If you really want to go back to one of the early metal bands, you have to look at Mutcheer. Nobody talks about very often because they were kind of a blip on the screen, but they were at one point the loudest, most metallic trio going.
Heavy metal is, of course, in the lyrics of Born to Be Wild, which was written by Canadian Dennis Edmonton / Mars Bonfire. He was really talking about that whole experience of, you know, big bikes and roaring down the highway.
For me, my awareness of it came with Led Zeppelin. It really did. That as soon as those guys launched, people started using the term heavy metal. And I knew instantly that that sound was heavy something.
As it is today, probably Deep Purple. You know, because they were the first to have this great big fuck-off PA, you know. And the first to have a lot of pyrotechnics, really.
Actually, the first time heavy metal was ever used was used as about Alice Cooper in Rolling Stone magazine. Rolling Stone magazine was doing an interview with us, I think in 71, 72, 73, something like that. And there was this picture of this giant guy holding me up, and it said, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, it's heavy metal, in quotes.
Every metal band owes a debt musically to Black Sabbath. They were the original.
Indeed. First metal band ever, Black Sabbath.
Yeah. Every cool riff has already been written by Black Sabbath. Anything anyone else does is just basically ripping it off. You're either playing it slightly different or backwards or faster or slow, but it's they did everything already.
For my money, Black Sabbath reigns as the first heavy metal band. It was here on the gritty streets of Birmingham, England in 1970 where Sabbath took music to a darker, more sinister place. Most people associate Black Sabbath with Ozzy Osbourne, now known as a reality TV dad. But it was Tony Iommi, Sabbath's guitarist, who is responsible for creating the band's sound and the first true heavy metal riffs.
When I first heard the term heavy metal, I hadn't got the faintest idea what they were talking about, which was many years ago, when I was doing an interview and somebody said, oh, about this heavy metal, and what? What's that? It just happened that I came up with a sort of music that everybody liked, and when we first started writing riffs, and then Black Sabbath, and Black Sabbath just seemed so different. Mm. Those few notes, you know, that sort of said it all, and we thought, God, this is great. We loved it. We loved the vibe. We got your hairs come up on your arm, you know, and it just gave us a great feeling of this is what we're about, you know. The sound being, you know, demonic, it just appealed to us. It appealed to we liked what we were doing. We liked the idea of those evilly sort of sounding riffs.
Since Black Sabbath, the sound of evil has become a defining element of heavy metal. But what makes metal sound evil?
The blues scale has the flat fifth, the tritone. That's the devil's note. Like in the old days, you weren't allowed to use that note. But Black Sabbath, their title song, you know, Black Sabbath is totally working the diminished fifth, the tritone.
You know, in the Middle Ages, the tritone was identified as the music of the devil because it apparently was the sound one used to call up the beast. There's something very sexual about the sound of the tritone. I think that in the Middle Ages, people who were ignorant and scared, when they heard something like that and felt that reaction inside their body, went, uh-oh, here comes the devil.
There's an ongoing battle in heavy metal to be more evil than the band that came before you. This has kept me into metal all these years. But there's more to this music than just sounding evil.
If you don't have an electric guitar with really good amps and really good distortion, you don't have the core of metal. You also need to have a really strong bass sound in it, bass with the bass guitarist and bass with the bass drums.
And then usually a vocalist who soared over top of all of that stuff with usually a fairly high voice.
They can't be soft, cute, sly. They have to be leather-lunged in one way or another.
White man came across the sea. He brought us pain and misery. He killed our tribes. He killed
was a kid practicing air guitar leaps off my front porch, my band of choice was Iron Maiden. I memorized every note, every riff, and every solo. Maiden was part of the new wave of British heavy metal, a movement that built on the foundation laid by early metal bands. They honed a sound that was faster, heavier, and more melodic than their predecessors. Well, now I'm on my way to interview Maiden's legendary singer, Bruce Dickinson. And if the 12-year-old Sam knew about this, he'd be freaking out. But I gotta keep it together, even though I'm interviewing him on the stage of London's famous venue, the Hammersmith Odeon.
I better start talking then.
My intention as a frontman is to try and find the guy who's right at the back of the 30,000 festival and sort of go, yeah, you. Yeah, you. You. And the guy goes, like that. And you can do that. You can actually do that.
Heavy metal, it doesn't even matter, the microphone's there, but you still got to sound like you're projecting to the back of the hall, like there's a tremendous effort involved. And so you get the return in, I think, particularly people like Bruce Dickinson of Iron Maiden or Rob Halford of Judas Priest, of this very operatic style of vocal production that was developed in the 19th century before amplification in order to reach the back of the hall.
You're warming up the whole crowd. On a good night, when it all works, it shrinks whatever arena you're in, and it should, by the end of the, you know, me in particular, because I'm the guy usually yelling at everybody and running around, it should feel like you've shrunk the place to the size of your thumb, where you can go, yep, all together.
Good night!
Dickinson's operatic vocal style has had an enormous impact on heavy metal music. And although people don't associate metal with virtuosic styles of music like classical or opera, it's these influences that make metal unique.